This is the building block of the building you see. This is an enlarged model of just one of the trillions of cells that make up our body. A human being consists of 35 trillion cells like this. 150 years ago, it was known that the building block of a human being was the cell, but scientists thought the cell was like a jelly particle. So our cells looked like these bricks. German zoologist Ernst Haeckel, who lived at that time, defines the cell as follows: a simple bubble filled with jelly. He was right to say this because the microscopes of that day did not show anything more. Scientists have been working for 150 years to decipher the structure of the cells that make up our bodies. It still hasn't been fully solved to this day. Professor Bruce Alberts is one of the world's most important names in molecular biology. He served for many years as president of the U.S. National Academy of Sciences and as editor-in-chief of the academic journal Science. He spent 50 years in laboratories. He is the main author of the most important textbook on cells. This is that book, 1,600 pages in total. This book is used as a textbook and reference book in all universities. He's describing this model. These are the authors. It explains the structure and function of organelles in the cell in detail. The fourth chapter covers chromosomes and genes, 67 pages. DNA's repair mechanism. For example, this section explains the communication mechanisms of the cell. The last part is the immune system, self-protection of the cell. It is explained in 60 pages. It draws from academic articles, experiments, and analyses carried out over decades. Now, a question for you. How many Nobel Prizes have been awarded to date for cell-related research? How many scientists have won the Nobel Prize for their research on cells? Here is the list. In 1906, Camillo Golgi discovers the processing, packaging, and transport of proteins in the cell, the eponym of the Golgi apparatus. In 1933, it was discovered how hereditary characteristics in cells are transmitted from parents to children. In 1958, a protein called insulin was discovered inside the cell. In 1959, they made important findings regarding the functions of DNA and RNA. These people have dedicated their lives to solving the cell. 1962 is the most important year for biology. The structure of DNA was largely solved. In 1963, it was discovered how nerve cells transmit electrical signals. In 1972, the bodily functions of proteins in the cell were discovered. In 1974, these scientists discovered how the lysosome works and how the recycling mechanism functions within the cell. In 1978, a problem that had remained unsolved for many years was solved, discovering how mitochondria produce energy. When the cell is completely solved, the human body will be largely explained. In 1986, the mystery of cell growth and proliferation and the factors that enable this were discovered. In 1989, it was discovered that RNA not only carries information, but also triggers chemical reactions. In 1991, a system for opening and closing small passages within the cell membrane is discovered. In 1996, we learned how the immune system detects virus-infected cells. In 1999, we discovered how the transport and cargo systems of proteins work inside the cell. In 2000, we learned how nerve cells send signals to each other in order to communicate. In 2002, the effects of genes in cells on the formation of organs and the death of cells were discovered. This year, special channels that allow cells to transport water were discovered. In the same year, the structure of ion channels that transmit electrical signals in cells is deciphered. 2006 was a very important year. The method of copying genetic information from DNA to RNA was discovered. In 2009, the structure and function of ribosomes, the most important organelle of the cell, were unraveled. In 2014 is an important year. We discovered how the GPS system, or navigation in our brain cells, works. 2015 is the year Aziz Sankar received the award. Sankar, together with two other scientists, discovered how DNA automatically repairs itself when damaged. In 2016, the cell's system for breaking down unnecessary particles and cleaning itself was discovered. In other words, we discovered the cell's recycling system. In 2018, a new way to treat cancer was found using the cell's immune system. So, how long does it take to discover this? James Allison has spent 33 years researching this topic. Tasuku Hanjo spent 44 years of his life researching this subject in laboratories. And finally, they received the Nobel Prize together in 2018. And in 2024, the critical roles of microRNA in disease processes in cells were discovered. Yes, 93 Nobel Prizes have been awarded for cell-related research, but the miraculous structure of the cell has not yet been completely unraveled. A subject that was unknown 150 years ago still retains many mysteries today. This is what it looks like. I see a car driving on the road. I don't see its engine. I think it just has a hood. Looking from a distance, it seems like it has a simple mechanism. Then when I open the hood, I see that it is a magnificent engine. The brilliance of the engine increases my admiration for the engineers who built it. The cell is a unique work of art, the common foundation brick of plants, animals, and all living things on Earth. Let's think about it this way. Let's call upon a group of engineers with the capacity and intelligence to receive a Nobel Prize. What if we gave them a latest model car engine and asked them to figure it out? How long will it take them to solve this? 3 months at most. They solve all the mysteries of that car in 3 months. For this reason, the cell is an inaccessible work of art with its magnificent structure. Is it possible to see a work of art but not see the artist? Yes, if a person does not want to see, they will not see. They will try to find a way to escape. Professor Dr. Ali Demersoy is one of the biologists who thinks that all living things on Earth came into being by chance and coincidence. Professor Dr. Ali Demersoy says the following about the cell. The crux of the matter is how mitochondria acquired this feature, because even a single individual gaining this characteristic by chance requires an accumulation of probabilities that are too extreme to be imagined. Consider cytochrome C. The probability of cytochrome C producing a specific amino acid sequence is as small as the probability of a monkey typing the history of humanity without making any mistakes, assuming the monkey is pressing random keys. In this case, we assume that enzymes emerged as much shorter molecules and that only certain amino acids needed to exist in certain places. What do you understand from this sentence? We assume that certain amino acids needed to exist in certain places. So, he says it happened on its own, and we can move on. Here, although it is quite contrary to scientific thought, in order to avoid a more dogmatic explanation and speculation, we have to accept that all respiratory enzymes were present in the cell at once before coming into contact with oxygen. The aim is to not speculate or make a more dogmatic statement. More precisely, this is what he is implying. We have to say this because we do not want to see the power of God.